Yes. What do these statements tell you about Anne Frank as a person? Number one, we don't seem to be able to get closer, and that's the problem. Maybe it's my fault that we don't confide in each other. I don't want to jot down the facts in this diary the way most people do, but I want the diary to be my friend. 3. Margaret went to Holland in December and I followed in February. When I was plunked down on the table as a birthday present for Maggot. Margaret, if you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. But teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. You don't know who they're going to pass, who they're going to keep back. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words. But the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. Number one answer, Annie is very reserved. Number two, she is self-confident and inventive. Three, she is humorous as well. Four, she is intelligent. Five, she has a sense of propriety and convincing attitude. She takes call. She takes it as her own call. She takes stand for anything which she has to prove. So she has a sense of propriety, you know, she takes ownership and a convincing attitude. Match the compound words with under A with their meanings under B. Use each in a sentence. Heartbreaking is producing great sadness. Homesick is missing home and family very much. Blockhead is an informal word which means a very stupid person. Law abiding is obeying and respecting the law. Overdue is do something to an excessive degree. Daydream is think about pleasant things, forgetting about the present. Think about pleasant things, forgetting about the present. Seven is breakdown. Breakdown is an occasion when vehicles, machines stop working. And output is something produced by a person, machine, or organization. Okay? The second one is now find the sentences in the lesson that have the phrasal verbs given below. Match them in their meanings. You have already found the meanings of some of them. Are their meanings the same as that of their parts? Note that two parts of a phrasal verb may occur separated in the text. Plunge in. Go straight to the topic. Kept back. Stay indoors. Move up is go to the next grade. And ramble on is speak or write without focus. Get along is have a good relationship with. And what is this? Six is calm down. Calm down is what can I say? Calm down here says as in make them remain quiet or keep quiet is calm down. And seven is stay in is stay indoors. एंड एट इज मेकअप फॉर इज कॉम्पनसेट, नाइन इज हैंड इन दैट इज गिव एन असाइनमेंट होमवर्क टू अ पर्सन इन अथॉरिटी द टीचर हैंड इन give back your homework, hand in your homework to that teacher. Okay. Here are few sentences from the text which have idiomatic expressions. Can you say what each means? You might want to consult a dictionary first. Our entire class is quaking in its boots, shaking with fear and nervous. Until then, we kept telling each other not to lose heart. Not to lose heart means don't lose hope, don't be negative. Not to think about negative side, but hope for the best. Mr. Keesing annoyed me for ages because I talked so much. For quite a long time. The answer is quite a long time. Mr. Keesing was trying to play a joke on me with his ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. Joke would be on him only. Sure, but I would make sure the joke was on him. That the joke should hit him only, not anybody else. Here are few more idiomatic expressions that occur in the text. Try to use them in sentences of your own. Caught my eye. While I was in the market, a beautiful purse had caught my eye, or a beautiful girl caught my eye, or a smart young kid caught my eye, a beautiful jacket caught your eye, you know, catch your eye, you know, you like that. He'd had enough. The teacher said that they had enough and he wanted all the notebooks by Wednesday. Okay. He laughed ourselves silly on his stupid jokes. I can't bring myself to terms with this tragedy. Break somebody's heart. It is not a good habit to break somebody's heart. Close to heart, I am very close to my father's heart. From the bottom of your heart, I thank you. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for being my mentor. Have a heart. I request you to have a heart and look again at my application. Have a heart of stone. It is said that people like Hitler have a heart of stone. Your heart goes out to somebody. As I looked at the shabbily dressed children up, my heart went out to them. You know, you feel sad for someone. So we are done with this, and it's going to be there. So great. What we are going to do is the next time we are going to come up with your English part. We will be doing the Amanda, the poem, right? So let's see. In the next video, I should come up with Amanda and we will try to do something with that. Okay. So till then, take care. Bye bye, and best of luck for everything.